We're back with Leah Bernstein, president of Mountain Apple Company.
You're involved with a number of personal, like, groups, women groups and other groups. Why are you doing that, and maybe some of the things that you're involved and what you're learning from it?
Well, for women around the world, Carrie's question earlier was very, very real, and a lot of women need mentoring. They need to know that you can climb above the glass ceiling, if as it were. And I try and give back, because I was given so much by two very powerful women, and I just try and find ways to give back in different, you know, of course I belong to NOW, the National Organization of Women. I belong to a lot of different organizations that just try and help women in developing countries and put them into their own businesses. And so it's kind of an exciting world out there right now, especially for women, because they're supporting themselves and getting ahead in every way, shape, and form.
And you're right, there's not a lot of women mentors available because there's a lot more male businessmen. For our females out there, are you able to give us some advice in regards to life or business of what we need to keep in mind to be successful in what we do?
We're smarter than anything and anybody, so we can just sit there and do what we do best. We don't need to worry about the fact that we're female. I think that a lot of women get caught up in the fact that I could never get ahead because I'm a woman, or I could never get to the CEO position of this company or that company because I'm female. One of my heroes in this community is Connie Lau. Connie Lau is CEO of Hawaiian Electric Industries and of American Savings Bank. And, I mean, it's just remarkable that this woman is able to do that. And as one of, it's a handful of women across the country that are in Fortune 500 companies, are the CEOs of Fortune 500 companies. So she's definitely one of my heroes. And I try and tell any young woman that says, how do you do this? And why are you doing it? And is that, forget about the fact that you're female. It doesn't matter that you're female. What matters is that you're dedicated, that you're passionate, and that you're smart. And that you can do it. There's no doubt you can do it. And I think the female gender is a little bit more adept at multitasking. So most women I know are raising families and keeping households and working full-time, if not more than full-time.
What's the most inspirational story that you like to tell maybe some of the women that you're mentoring? Something maybe you've learned in a conference or your mentors or so on.
Well, a young woman, I was asked to speak to a Sacred Hearts class. Actually, they came to our office here, and when I was called by the counselor, he just said to me, I want to just show the girls in our senior class that they can get past the glass ceiling, that they can do it. And so they came, and we talked for a while, and there was one young lady that would not leave my side. She just stayed glued to me the whole 2 or 3 hours that we were together with this class of 20-year-olds. And as I was walking them to the door and saying goodbye, she said to me very, very forcefully, I'm going to own my own record company one day, and I want to start working for you tomorrow. And I was so impressed by her zeal and by her motivation, by her, you know, excitement, that I basically just said, have your mom call me. And because I wanted to make sure it was okay with her parents that she worked part-time. And she started very quickly. She started within the next week or so. Her parents did stop her down from working the next day because she had tests and finals. And so she started working for me. And today she's working for Universal Music in San Francisco. And she's just wonderful. She's just a great... She worked for Mountain Apple for about 3 years. And then she decided to continue her education on the mainland. And she's an inspiration to me because she really, really did... She just put her mind to it, and this is what she wanted to do, and that was it. And I really had doubts that she would stick with it. I thought, once she gets into it and realizes we could be selling widgets or anything, because the music business is fun and it's exciting and you get to see a lot of creation, but in the end, it's selling a product. And you could be doing, you know, we could be selling shoes today, but we're selling things that make people happy.
Thanks for joining us today on Greater Good Radio. For more information or a transcript of today's show, please visit us online at greatergoodradio.com. This is your host, Evan Leong and Carrie Leong, saying please join us next time for another episode of Greater Good Radio Hawaii.